When the organized criminals start working overtime to eliminate all means of contesting their power over their victims through censorship and gun control, we are in the final push towards tyranny. Benjamin Franklin once said, "Democracy is two wolves and a lamb voting on what to have for lunch. Liberty is a well-armed lamb contesting the vote." When a population becomes distracted by trivia, when cultural life is redefined as a perpetual round of entertainments, when serious public conversation becomes a form of baby talk, when, in short, a people become an audience and their public business a vaudeville act, then a nation finds itself at risk. A culture death is a clear possibility. Said Professor Neil Postman during Amusing Ourselves to Death, Discourse in the Age of Show Business. Americans get confused. They see a massive group of migrants marching towards the border. The march is reported on as if it was some kind of organic event that has just sprang up. The migrants are presented as if they are no different than any other people coming to the United States looking for a better life. But they are different. The march is orchestrated and masses of poor people entering the country have great economic benefit to the elite who finance and organize these events. The Founding Fathers were right that with democracy, some potential threats would have to be addressed. They did not anticipate that organized crime would take over the country. There is talk about the shadow government. There really is no such thing. It is organized crime that dictates policy to Congress. It is organized crime that causes senators and congressmen to step down when their re-election is a sure thing. But many Americans benefit from the things organized crime does. That is temporary, but some Americans will always benefit, and that makes it difficult to re-establish law and order. The Founding Fathers, like all historical figures, were not at all like they have always been popularly portrayed. They were motivated out of self-interest like all living entities are. The Founding Fathers did not provide a method for testing the constitutionality of laws. They may very well have purposefully left openings for the exploitation of ordinary people. The Supreme Court, a political body, ended up with the role of deciding constitutionality of laws. The bankers control the governments of the world and are cheapening the cost of money by enticing people to go deeper in debt. The rich always seek clever ways to suck more wealth through bondage to their debt. In our governments, where the federal courts were concerned, they sought to diminish the role of politics by making appointments lifetime appointments. Impeachment and the option to limit the jurisdiction of inferior federal courts were tools to punish or thwart those who refused a la Thomas A. Becket to take the duty and importance of their office to heart and put aside base personal interest. The power to decide cases arising under this Constitution is a way of testing constitutionality. You are quite right that criminals and traitors found new sophisticated systems of exploiting weaknesses in providing for the exercise of popular sovereignty, not democracy. Just how large a log has been jammed down the throat of the people of this country is hard to see in every detail, but it is nonetheless a massive one. The will of the people is now only a concept that is a sad, sad joke. Still, there's no getting around the fact that the people handed all their power away with the 14th, 15th, 16th, 17th, and 19th Amendments and thought themselves fine fellows indeed. The incentive to serve is completely imaginary. Anyone who is elected to office will act based on self-interest unless constituents stop him from doing so. Self-interest is the only universal incentive mankind has. Is that bad? In my analysis, there is no bad or good. That is just the way it is. Wanting it to be otherwise makes no difference. The popular assumption is that representatives actually do have an incentive to serve. It is also assumed that when folks go to work in the public sector that self-interest disappears. That doesn't happen. Instead, where the incentive to economize is part of a free market system, that incentive is reversed when work is done in the public sector. It is hard for self-government to work well when the public is convinced government works one way when it actually works in an opposite way. Such that it is, the realm of political theater with all of its drama, vitriol and scripted theatrics is what passes for transparent government today, with elected officials, entrusted to act in the best interests of their constituents, routinely performing for their audiences and playing up to the cameras, while doing very little to move the country forward. Yet behind the footlights, those who really run the show are putting into place policies which erode our freedoms and undermine our attempts at contributing to the workings of our government, leaving us none the wiser and bereft of any opportunity to voice our discontent or engage in any kind of discourse until it's too late. It's the oldest con game in the books, the magician's sleight of hand that keeps you focused on the shell game in front of you while your wallet is being picked clean by ruffians in your midst. Indeed, while mainstream America has been fixated on the drama-filled reality show being televised from the White House, the American police state has moved steadily forward. Set against a backdrop of government surveillance, militarized police, SWAT team raids, asset forfeiture, eminent domain, overcriminalization, armed surveillance drones, whole-body scanners, stop-and-frisk searches, roving VIPR raids and the like, all of which have been sanctioned by Congress, the White House and the courts, our constitutional freedoms have been steadily chipped away at, undermined, eroded, whittled down, and generally discarded. Our losses are mounting with every passing day. The United States of America is not a democracy and never was, to the republic for which we stand as a constitutional exacting. The big lie, that America is a democracy is contrary to the Founding Fathers' vision. George Washington was against any political affiliation and only joined the Federalist Party 4 years in his bid for the re-election that he won. Democracy was an epithet, said Joseph Ellis, author of the Pulitzer-winning book Founding Brothers, The Revolutionary Generation, from book Democracy Meant Mob Rule. Democracy meant conceding the issue to people who don't understand it. The Constitution and the Bill of Rights never mention democracy, only idealizing a republic. Harvard law professor Lawrence Lessig said, "There is nothing more dangerous than a government of the many controlled by the few," end of quote. The U.S. government remains the greatest threat to our freedoms. The systemic violence being perpetrated by agents of the government has done more collective harm to the American people and our liberties than any single act of terror. More than terrorism, more than domestic extremism, more than gun violence and organized crime, the U.S. government has become a greater menace to the life, liberty and property of its citizens than any of the so-called dangers from which the government claims to protect us. This is how tyranny rises and freedom falls, when the government views itself as superior to the citizenry, when it no longer operates for the benefit of the people, when the people are no longer able to peacefully reform their government, when government officials cease to act like public servants, when elected officials no longer represent the will of the people, when the government routinely violates the rights of the people and perpetrates more violence against the citizenry than the criminal class, when government spending is unaccountable and unaccounted for, when the Judiciary Act is courts of order rather than justice, and when the government is no longer bound by the laws of the Constitution, then you no longer have a government of the people, by the people and for the people. What we have is a government of wolves. This was the Atlantis Report. Please like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.